I'm Dr. Leo Riella, Director of Kidney Transplantation at Mass General Hospital, head of the Riella Lab, and associate professor at Harvard Medical School. I'd like to share with you some of our recent published results in the Journal of Clinical Investigation. My lab is focused on understanding the mechanisms of immune regulation to develop smarter and more efficient ways to control the immune system and prevent organ rejection after transplantation. The immune system is our body's army, charged with protecting us around the clock against all foreign enemies like bacteria and viruses. In transplantation, the transplanted organ is recognized as a foreign intruder and a threat by the immune system. To avoid rejection of the transplant organ, transplanted patients must take a combination of medications to weaken the immune system. However, it's important to understand that immune suppressive medications affect the whole immune system, not just the immune cells that attack the transplanted organ. As a result, these medications also block the immune system's ability to fight actual threats to the body, like bacteria, viruses, fungi, and even cancer cells. These meds also have many side effects, such as diabetes and kidney toxicity. Since the first kidney transplant more than 50 years ago, little has changed in our approach to prevent rejection after transplant. However, we have learned in the past years that the immune system is composed not only of soldiers, but also of generals, specialized immune regulatory cells that prevent the immune response from being exaggerated or inappropriate. One dominant cell that provides this immune regulation is the regulatory T cells, or Tregs. Tregs are specialized immune cells that exert their suppressive function in the immune system through various mechanisms, including the secretion of inhibitory cytokines and the expression of suppressive surface markers. Tregs are critical mediators of tolerance. In transplantation, Tregs play a crucial role in suppressing the effector T cells that lead to transplant organ rejection. In our current study, we designed a novel molecule that expands regulatory T cells and showed that it prolongs transplant survival in multiple preclinical models. We hope that this approach will impact transplanted patients by boosting the body's own immune regulatory arm to protect the transplant organ against rejection, while reducing at the same time the requirement for high doses of immune suppressive drugs and their associated side effects. Dr. Effie and Dr. Borges, who led this research in my lab, will share with us more details about this exciting work.
In this current JCI paper, we investigate a strategy to boost the regulatory T cells by developing a novel drug that targets the high-affinity L2 receptor, primarily in Tregs. L2 signaling through its receptor is essential for development and function of Tregs. Previous studies using recombinant or modified versions of L2 show that although they can expand Tregs, they can either have a short half-life or lead to unwanted expansion of inflammatory immune cells like NK and effector T cells, limiting their use in the clinic. Hence, we design a modified L2 that has a strong preference for the Tregs and stays active in the body for a longer time. We achieve this by inducing mutations to L2 and combining it with an Fc domain of a human IgG, resulting in a drug called mutein L2. In our experiments in mice, we found that our mutein L2 could selectively and effectively increase the number of Tregs by fourfold. In addition, this mutein L2 expanded Tregs had enhanced suppressive function. This enhancement of Tregs helped the mice's immune system to tolerate and accept transplant skins from mismatched donors without the need of high doses of immunosuppressive drugs. This beneficial effect of mutein L2 was confirmed in three different skin transplant models.
We also showed that mutein L2 overcomes the adverse effects of commonly used immunosuppressive drugs on Tregs and prolongs transplant survival even in the strongest skin transplantation model. Since our ultimate goal is to use mutein L2 in transplant patients, we tested this mutein IL-2 in monkeys and human immune cells in a humanized mouse model and found similar positive effects in expanding Tregs. Overall, our paper demonstrated that mutein IL-2 could be a way to improve the success of organ transplants by enhancing the body's ability to tolerate the new organ, potentially reducing the need for long-term immunosuppressive drugs and their associated toxicities. Using this knowledge, our lab is poised to change the paradigm of rejection prevention in transplantation by focusing on selectively enhancing the body's own immune regulatory arm to protect the transplanted organ against rejection instead of weakening the whole immune system.
We would like to thank all our collaborators at MGH for their assistance on this project and also our partnership and support from Vistera, especially Greg and Zach.